to the fifth episode of the Crazy Sock Lady podcast. My name is Kay, and you can find me as Kay Litton on Instagram and Ravelry. And there is also a Crazy Sock Lady podcast group, so you can head over there and introduce yourself. And that is where all of the knit along and giveaway info will be posted for anything that we have going on right now. So thank you for joining me this morning. If you are a new viewer, welcome, and I hope you enjoy. If you're a returning viewer, thank you for coming back for another episode. It is October 11th, and it is not even 8 a.m. It's probably about 7:30 in the morning. I just got back from dropping my youngest off at the bus stop and came back and got set up. My oldest is in his room. He is feeling a little under the weather today. He's had a little bit of a cough lately, and I think it's probably just allergies, but it was a little bit worse this morning and he's pretty stuffy, so he was not feeling too great, so he wanted to stay home and rest. So he is in there all snuggled up in his bed. So if you hear any coughing, that is him. So we had an interesting weekend. If you follow me on Instagram, I kind of posted some pictures and videos of our weekend visit from Hurricane Matthew. And we are mostly cleaned up today. I'm looking at our yard behind the camera and it's still got little bits of stuff everywhere, branches and leaves, but the big stuff is cleaned up. It was interesting. That was our first hurricane that we've been through. We lived in Florida on the Gulf Coast for a while, and surprisingly enough, we never had a hurricane there. We lived there twice, 3 years one time, and maybe 2 years the other time. We never had a hurricane. Never. This was our first one, and we were as prepared as we could be. My last week has been preparing for the hurricane, clean up after the hurricane. So it hit Saturday, and it started with just a little bit of rain, then a lot of rain, then more rain, and we kind of thought, you know, as the day kept getting later into the evening, we were like, oh, maybe this is all we're gonna get is just a bunch of rain. We were wrong. We were so wrong. The kids went to bed about 8:30, still just raining at that point. I went to bed 10 something, I'm gonna say. Still just rain, and I think I probably jinxed us because I thought, this is it. I think I even said at one point, well, this is all we're gonna get. And then I was asleep for maybe 15 minutes. Within those 15 minutes, all hell broke loose. It was insane. You could just hear that wind. I mean, it was only a category one when it hit us, so there are a lot worse. But I cannot wrap my brain around the fact that it can get worse than it did here. Than that wind that we heard here, I just cannot comprehend that it gets worse than that. It just blows my mind. The wind was insane. I'm not sure exactly what woke me up, if it was the sound of the wind or something hitting the house, because it seemed like most of the stuff was coming at the side of the house where our master bedroom was on. So I'm laying in bed and you just kept hearing things hitting the side of the house, and so I was up and down all night long. My husband stayed up almost all night. He didn't try to come to bed until, well, I don't know what time. But yeah, it was crazy. And we would hear things hit the roof on our side where the master bedroom is, and you could just hear them scrape all the way across the full length of the house on the roof. And I think it made it even worse that it was at night, because in the daytime you can at least see what's blowing around out there. You can maybe kind of peek out a window and see what just hit your house. At night, we could see nothing. It was pitch black. Power was out. You couldn't see a thing. Outside, you couldn't see a thing. Inside, we could kind of look up out the windows and see the tops of the trees against the sky. It probably wasn't the best idea because it was pretty terrifying the way those trees were swaying. I was sure that we were going to have a tree down, at least in the yard, if not on the house. I mean, we got very, very lucky. The fact that we have no damage to our house other than on the back side of the house, one of the outside lights did get broken, and we had a few shingles off the roof, but that was it. Other than that, it was just yard cleanup. We had a lot of branches down in the yard, a lot of pine needles, leaves. So lucky to think about the people that lost their homes and people that died. I mean, we got very, very lucky. And like I said, I just cannot wrap my mind around winds worse than what they were here. I don't know, I think category one is the most I'll stay for. Category two or above, I think we might get the heck out, go evacuate further inland, because that was not fun. And we lost power. It was, I don't know, probably 2 a.m. Sunday morning is when it went out for good, because it went out a little bit earlier, but it did eventually come back on for a few hours. And then it went out again, and it was out until Monday afternoon. And that's a long time without power. You know, there are people that have it worse, and they're going to be without power for a lot longer. So we were lucky that it did come back on. They were originally saying October 16th was going to be when our power came back on. I thought, oh my goodness. And I should say, you know, the no power thing, it's an inconvenience, yes, but you can manage without power. Where we are, though, and we are probably one of the only homes in our neighborhood still on this, but we are on well water. So when the power goes out, we not only don't have power, but we have no water, because our well pump is electric. So there is no water pumping from our well when the power is out. We did have a little bit of water that was in the water tank in the garage. And once that was gone, we had no running water. And we knew that was gonna happen. You know, if the power went out, we knew we would not have running water. So we had filled up. We only have one bathtub. The master bath has just a stall shower. So we had filled up the bathtub that we had. We had purchased a ton of water. So we were prepared. But I was thinking with those dates, you know, I went online to see what the estimated date for it to be turned back on, and I saw the 16th. I was panicking a little, because that is a long time to be not just without power, but without running water. So yeah, I think category one was our little test here, to see how prepared we were for a hurricane, and I think we did pretty good. And we know now, for the next hurricane or major storm or snowstorm, what we need to do to prepare, what things we want to make sure that we have on hand that we didn't this time, things that we'll do differently. I definitely think that we are going to be investing in a generator so that we can at least keep the refrigerator going, because we threw so much food away this weekend. I just wanted to cry thinking about throwing away all the food in the fridge, in the freezer. Luckily, our deep freezer, we saved the majority of what was in the deep freezer. Some stuff did need to be thrown out, but the stuff that was on the bottom was still good. But yeah, we know what to do differently, and we are seeing about getting on county water now, because I think probably everyone else is out here, but this house that we are in now was a rental for so long. I think probably the previous tenants just didn't want to pay the money to be turned over to county water, and then pay the water bill as well. I mean, with well water, you don't have to worry about paying a water bill, so that's nice. But I think I've rambled enough about Hurricane Matthew. I usually always put pictures from our past week, so this time they will more than likely be Hurricane Matthew related. Give you a little peek, if you don't follow me on Instagram, into what the weekend held for us. But yeah, you're not here to hear about Hurricane Matthew, you're here about knitting. So maybe we should get into that. Okay, I did get lots of knitting done during Hurricane Matthew. I guess I'm not done talking about it, because I do want to say this. I got a ton of knitting done, and I told my family I have the best hobby for when the power goes out. You don't need electric to knit. Granted, you know, when it's dark, you do need some form of light, but there are always candles, lanterns, or headlamps. Yeah, if you follow me on Instagram, you saw that picture, and I think My family probably thought I was nuts. I wore that headlamp Sunday night all around the house. As soon as it got dark, it was on my head. I knitted with it. I read with it. I brushed my teeth with it on. I did everything. Yeah, that was a pretty good investment, I think. And my boys gave me the idea. My dad and his girlfriend, when they were here, they bought the boys some headlamps. And I thought, that's genius. When I was getting ready for Hurricane Matthew, I thought, I need a headlamp for when the power goes out. I can just knit my headlamp. So that is what I did, and it worked brilliantly. So have one on hand, knitters, so that when the power goes out, you just have this perfect light. It worked perfect. So I will definitely keep that with my knitting stuff, and I might buy a few more just to have on hand because it worked so good and the boys wore theirs. But yeah, that will be it about Hurricane Matthew. Maybe, we'll see. But admin stuff, I don't really have a lot of admin stuff to get through. Just wanted to mention that we do still have the gift knit along going on right now, and that thread is open. There is a chatter and FO thread in my Ravelry group, and I am co-hosting that with Jessamine of the Knitted Towel podcast, and she also has chatter and FO threads open in her group, and that will close on November 30th. We will both be drawing for prizes out of our separate groups, so be sure to enter in both places and be members of the group to enter. And you can enter anything in there that you are knitting, crocheting for a Christmas gift. Anything you're going to be giving as a Christmas gift, you can enter into that. So be sure to get motivated and get your Christmas knitting going. I did get some more done on one of my Christmas gifts that I will show you in WIPs. So that was exciting that I got some more done on mine. I hope you all are doing good with your Christmas knitting. I know I tend to put it off, and it's just a mad rush, and I think that's what it's going to be again this year because I keep getting distracted, very distracted by other things. I'm trying very hard to stay on track, but it's not working so well. I need like a kick in the tush to really get me going here because I'm a slacker with my Christmas knitting. It's so bad. But yeah, the knit along threads are in the Crazy Sock Lady podcast Ravelry group. You can enter into there. And like I said, it closes on November 30th. I wrote down November 1st. I don't know why. And if I said that the first time, ignore that. It is November 30th. So that is it for admin stuff. Now we will go into FOs. And I do have 3, 4, I'm going to count the other one that I'll show. But the first one that I'm going to show, I did Wyatt's winter hat, and it is done. And it fits him so good. For this, I use the Cupid's Mix Beanie, I believe is the name of it. And that is a free pattern on Ravelry, and it is just out of sock yarn, so it's kind of like a sock head hat. And I did it on 2.25 millimeter, just with some red sock yarn. All of this is in the info is in my projects page on Ravelry, if you're interested in the name of the yarn, because I cannot remember it off the top of my head. I never can. But yeah, it's done. It fits him. And he probably should have worn it this morning because it's pretty chilly here this morning. It's only in the 50s. I don't think it's gotten up to the 60s yet. So yeah, I've got a hoodie on this morning. The kids were bundled up, per why it was when he left the house. Austin's still here, but he was all bundled up and the heat wasn't working on the bus, the poor kid. So he really probably needed his hat this morning. The heat wasn't working. The ferry's not running, so they have to drive all the way around. We live right by the ferry. So when they get on the bus, they usually go straight to the ferry. But with the hurricane, the water was up already. The ferry didn't run last week at all, so the water was already up. And then with the hurricane, it's of course even higher now, so the ferry will probably not be running for at least this week, maybe even longer. I don't know how long it'll take the water to go down. But so they have to go all the way around to where there is a bridge, and it ends up being about an hour and a half to school and then an hour and a half home. very, very, very long day for the poor kids. They get to school late and then they leave school early so that they don't get home too late. So yeah, it makes for a long day. And he probably could have used this morning. I told him, I said, you're gonna have to remember this week. Because the bus driver was like, the heat is not working. Do you have a blanket in there you can swim with him? And all I had was a beach towel. So he did take a beach towel. Gosh, guys, I'm a rambler this morning. How did I even get on to the ferry? And but yeah, Wyatt's hat is done. He loves it. So now I need to, I'll probably do Austin's next. My winter hat is done. Wyatt's is done. I need to do one for Austin and I need to do one for Eric. So one down, two more to go. Or I guess two down if you count mine. So two down, two more to go. But this pattern was nice. I wanted something that was like a sockhead hat. I obviously did not make a slouchy. He wanted just a fitted beanie. But I wanted something that was like a sockhead hat, but already had the counts figured out for a smaller size. It would have been so easy to do too, guys, but when I was starting this, I just did not have the brain space to try to figure out what to cast on for the smaller sizes. So I found that and it was a free pattern and it worked great. I just kept trying it on him until I thought it was time to do the decreases and just decreased and it fits perfect. So that is one FO. Second FO, I finished these just this weekend. These are for Eric, some fingerless gloves. And this pattern is the Paddle pattern by Tin Can Knits. It is a paid for pattern on Ravelry. And for these, I will be entering these into the Mean Girls Knits. They have a knit along going on in the Ravelry group for patterns by Tin Can Knits. Oh, that scared me. Did you guys hear that? That was my dog. My husband is on evening, so he's asleep right now. And our German Shepherd likes to lay by the bedroom door, and then she will roll over, flip over, and hit the bedroom door. And I know she does that all the time, but I don't know why that scared me. Oh my goodness. Okay, anyways. These are Eric's gloves. They are a little bit big on me, and they fit him good. Me, I would want them more fitted. Obviously, you know, this is a larger size than I would use for myself, but yeah. And what I think I'm going to do, I didn't check my gauge. Shocker, I know. Who needs to do that? Obviously, I needed to because I think these should be a little bit more fitted on him too. But he says he likes them. He promised. I told him I will redo them if he doesn't because I want them to be something that he loves to wear. But he likes them. But for mine, I'm going to do a pair for myself and a pair for Austin. And I will definitely do a smaller needle size. I think I'll just do the needle size. It calls for a smaller one for the ribbing and then a larger size for the rest of the glove. And I think I'll probably just stick with the size for the ribbing for the whole glove. I think that will work just to make it a little bit more fitted. I have a feeling that even this is a large. And measurement wise, I would be a medium. And I think even a medium wouldn't be, I don't know, I think it would still be a little baggy. I'm going to do Austin's next. Experiment on another pair and then I'll do mine. So we'll see how they work. But I like them. I didn't do the cuff down here as long as it called for. I kept trying it on him and that's the length he wanted. And he says he likes them, so. And for this, I just did Barocco Vintage DK. And there's no colorway on theirs, and I didn't bring the tag over to see what the number was. But if you're interested, it is in my projects page on Ravelry. I have been very good about keeping that up to date. Just in case anyone wants to know anything, I try to keep it up to date with what I'm working on and what I use and notes if I've changed anything. So if you're interested in something and I don't cover it, be sure to head over there. And if it's not in there, just message me and ask me. And let's see. I think that was it for those. They went super, super fast. very fast. I started it Saturday evening when it was still just raining outside, and I got so far and I thought, oh my gosh, I may have a whole glove done in one evening. Well, I got, how far did I get? Maybe up to here where I needed to separate and take these off, put them on waste yarn. Yeah, that's where I got, because when I started working back, you take the thumb off and you put it on waste yarn, and then I started working back on this part, my stitch count was off. And I thought, well, that's weird, because my count was on the entire time. Well, I had messed up in creases for the thumb gusset, like way back here. So I ripped out, and then I did a little bit more, and I was still off, so I had to rip back out, and I figured out what I did, and it was just a silly mistake, and it was probably just my nerves from the weekend and waiting for the storm that I just got. I don't know, I just messed up. So I had to take it back twice. So I told him he had better love them, he had better wear them a lot this winter, because I had to rip that one out twice. So the last, no, still have one tiny, tiny FO after this one. But I finished my fall socks. Yay, they are done. And this yarn was by Knit Mona on Etsy. And it is the Pumpkin Spice and Everything Nice colorway. And for these, I did these magic loop, toe up, 64 stitches, fish lips kiss heel, and 2x2 ribbing on a 2.25 millimeter needle. And I love this yarn, guys. This is probably one of my favorite fall yarns that I've gotten this year. It's very, very pretty, and it's very soft. This was my first time using yarn from Knit Mona. And this was just her, I can't remember exactly what the base is called, but just her basic sock base with merino and nylon. And it's nice. I would definitely recommend checking out her shop and seeing what all she has. She has some gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous colorways. And I will definitely be ordering from her sometime, very soon probably, because she's got some stuff that I want to get before it sells out or she doesn't do the colors anymore. So yeah, these were fun and these went really fast. I'm finding that toe up, magic loop, fish lips kiss heel just seems to go a lot faster for me than cuff down. And I don't know why. Cuff down used to go pretty fast. I mean, I didn't really think I was a slow knitter when I did cuff down, but there's just something about this, and I don't know if it's because I'm enjoying that I've learned the new techniques, the new way, you know, I just learned to do toe up, I just did magic loop on socks for the first time, I just learned fish lips kiss heel. So I don't know if it's just a combination of learning all those new things, and they're exciting and new, and I can't wait to do them, that it seems to go faster. But one of the whips that I'm going to show you, a Christmas knit, is not going as fast. And I think it's because I'm not as excited to work on it because it's cuffed down. And I probably could have figured it out to do toe up on it, but it's a pattern sock and I didn't feel like trying to figure all that out. So yeah, another FO. I got a ton of knitting done this past week. And my last baby FO here, I did, let's see, how many of these did I do? One, two, they're laying over on the table, so I'm counting. One, two, three, four, five, this six. I did six of these in the past week, and I have another one on the needles over there that I just have the cuff and the leg done. But I did, and I posted this on Instagram, little keychain socks. How adorable are these? And this I did with the Knit Mona yarn, little baby sock. And these I've got all packaged up to go out in some packages that I have to ship out today. But yeah, they are, it's just so cute and so easy and fun. Great way to use up scraps. And for that, I used the pattern that came with my keychain sock blocker, and I ordered this off of Knit Picks. And it comes with a pattern for a little sock to go on your keychain sock blocker. But I just have been using it and making my own little keychains. Thought that was a little something fun to add to swaps and different things that I have going on. So yeah, if you are expecting a package from me, you might be receiving one of these little goodies. And let's see, what is next? That is all for FOs this week, guys. I heard the door open. My oldest is out somewhere. And I'm just drinking water today. Ice water. That's it. We had no ice. I like my crushed ice in my drinks. And the power was out and we had no ice all weekend. So you have no idea how good cold drinks taste right now. They taste so good. Okay. That's it for FOs. And now whips. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 to show you. Let's just go down the list of how I wrote them down. And some of these I've showed and there's really not too much progress, so maybe I shouldn't really even be showing them. But the first one is my cupcake shawl. The pattern is by Gabrielle Knits. It is a paid for pattern on Ravelry. And it's moving along. I'm getting towards, I'm on the fourth section, I believe. Let me pull it out here and see. But I'm on the last section that I'll be doing the main collar in. And I am getting a little low on the yarn. So I'm hoping I don't have to play too much of a yarn chicken game here. But here it is. This is the top with the lace. And then it goes on down. That's where I was last week. So I got the rest of that section done and I'm into another section. If you can see that, there you go. So yeah, it's moving right along and I really, really like these collars. I'm enjoying the pattern. Right now it's an easy knit. I do have, the bottom section is lace, as you can see on the picture. So I do have a ton of lace to do when I get to the bottom, but I think that's a section you can do more or less of. I think there are, you know, tells you in there how to shorten or lengthen that section. So there's my cupcake shawl. And the yarn that I'm using is Lolo Did It. And this is all that I have left of my main collar. So I guess we'll see. I don't think I'm going to run out. If I do, I have some pink left. For Hello Gorgeous colorway. I believe that's the one I have from some socks that I did. So I could probably add a band of that in before I start the green. But I think I should be good. I was really, really worried last week when I had it out and working on it that I was not going to have enough. I had it at knitting and I, you know, was so worried. But I got their input and they agreed that some pink would look good if I do get to where I'm running out. So I think that's what I'll do if I think I'm going to run out, because the, you know, the rows get longer, so it's kind of hard. I'm sure I could figure out the math, weigh it and do all of that. But where's the adventure in that? Let's just see what's gonna happen, right? Be adventurous. So yeah, here's my cupcake shawl. And I can't wait to wear this. When I picked these collars, I can't remember how I came to these two together. She may have posted a picture of these, because if you do not follow Lolo Did It, you should, and you should try her yarn because I love the yarn. And she is very, very good, Lauren is, about posting pictures on Instagram. And I believe her new website, she is, I don't know if she's changed over yet, but she's in the process of going to just an actual website instead of Etsy. But anyways, her new website is going to have a section where she posts pictures of the speckled with the coordinating tonals. And that might have been where I got the idea for these two colorways together. This is, I love green. Purple, green, blues. Those are probably, I hate saying I have favorite colors, but those are probably the ones I lean the more towards. and something with a lot of pinks and, you know, I don't know that that's something that I truly would have picked for myself. I don't hate pink, but I don't gravitate towards pink. So I don't know why I really picked these two colors, but they look great together and I am actually loving it. I was not sure when I caked the speckled up how I was truly going to feel about it once I knit it up, but I'm loving it. I think it's going to be something fun, a little out of my comfort zone, something to brighten up the winter months and maybe wear into the spring when it's still a little bit cooler outside. So that is my cupcake shawl. Made a little bit of progress. I would like to at least be to the lace section by next time, maybe even have it started. We'll see. But I'm doing those on Chowgu needles. And I really like those for shawls. The cords are nice and sturdy. So that is that. And that is living in. You guys know I love this bag because I've shown it quite a few times. But this is my bag from Amber of Simple Love Made on Instagram and True Simple Love, I believe that's right, on Etsy. And I still am in love with this bag. I love it. My shawl might be getting a tiny bit too big for it, but it still fits. It still fits in there. So I'm going to use it because it is one of my favorites. It's nice and squishy. Okay, next. The name for these socks. This next whip has changed. They are no longer just Austin's Halloween socks. They are Austin's Halloween Nemo socks because I still cannot unsee the Nemo. And I have had some people agree that once they've seen something somewhere, they cannot unsee it. And that is how I feel about these socks. But I did get some progress done. I did not move my progress keeper up last time. I meant to. But I believe I was done. I had just finished one repeat of the orange and black and was into this white, I believe, last time. So I sat down, I worked on this Sunday night when we did not have power. This is what I was working on. And then I worked on it a little bit last night. I've got so much stuff to catch up on around the house from not having power all weekend. So I had to do some laundry last night and I'm going to be doing more laundry today. Doing some cleaning, so, but yeah, I did get more progress done on these, and they're going pretty fast. Like I said, Toe-It Magic Loop, I really like it. This is just 3 nights of work, and not for very long, because I don't knit a bunch in the evenings. I cannot stay awake. I'm very much a morning person, so I cannot stay awake in the evenings, but yeah, that is Halloween Nemo socks. And these are on a 2.25 millimeter Addy sock rocket. And my little bat progress keeper from Melissa of Knitty by Nature. And the yarn that I'm using, if you did not watch last week, you probably don't get the Nemo reference. But the yarn that I'm using, I purchased at one of my local yarn stores, the Salty Sheep, in Swansboro, North Carolina. And when I saw it, I did not read the name of the colorway. I just spotted it. I saw that it was self-striping and I thought Halloween socks for the boys. So I grabbed it. And then when I got to the register and I mentioned, you know, the lady that was checking me out, the owner was kind of asking, oh, you know, what are you gonna do with this? What are you gonna do with that? We were just chatting and I told her that this yarn was gonna be Halloween socks for my boys. And she said, or Nemo socks. And I just kind of looked at her and she's like, they're Nemo socks. They're clownfish. They are. It is Biscotti Yarns and the colorway is clownfish. And I showed this last week. But now they will forever be known as Austin's Halloween Nemo socks. And like I said last week, my husband sees Halloween. I asked the boys, because I wanted to make sure they were going to see Halloween when they saw them. My youngest would probably still not care if they were Nemo, but my oldest is a little bit too too old. You know, he thinks he is anyways for Nemo. So he would probably not want to wear Nemo socks. But yeah, he said they say that they see Halloween. So whatever, that works. But the heels, toes, and cuffs will be done in this. And it is Knit Pick Stroll Brights. And the colorway is Sour Apple. So that is that. I'm just going to work away on those. And hopefully, like I said last week, I want to be able to get both the boys' pairs out of this yarn with the coordinating green. I do not have any more of the clownfish, but I do have more of the green. So hopefully what I've got will be enough for shorty socks for both of them. And this is in my Mountain State Stitches Jack Skellington bag. Cute little progress keeper zipper pull. And I'm using the DPN holder that she sent with my bag. I love these. I've mentioned it quite a few times and I've shown that I use these, but I cannot recommend them enough. You do not have to worry about your stitches falling off or your needles. I'm always so afraid if I don't have one on there, because I don't have a ton of them. I need to get more of the DPN or needle cozies. You don't have to worry about your needles poking a hole in your bag. You know, we buy these nice project bags. I know we all do. And I would just hate for, you know, to go pick up my knitting and have a needle sticking out the side of the bag or something, because some of them are so sharp that they probably would just poke right through the fabric and the interfacing and everything. So I definitely recommend the needle cozies. Okay, that is that for Austin socks. And now I will show you the Christmas knit that I've been working on. Like I said last week, I kind of justified all of my other whips by saying I do have some Christmas knits already done. They are in the bottom of my hutch, packaged up. I mean, not gift wrapped yet, but they're packaged up, so they're safe. So I have some done, but I did get farther. Last time I showed this, I don't have a progress keeper on this. I am such a bad podcaster. I'm supposed to have progress keepers on all of these to show you. But last time, I know exactly where I was, because I was only 10 stitches in, or 10 rows in, to the 20 row cuff. So I finished the cuff, and I will put a progress keeper on this today, and I got two, maybe three pattern repeats done. And this is the Gravel Socks by Mina Phillip, part of her Beyond Vanilla Socks sock patterns. So yeah, I've got that far on the first sock, and it's fun. I'm really liking this pattern. I don't know, maybe once I do more of it, it'll be one that becomes just kind of intuitive and you don't need the pattern. But as of now, I still do need to glance at the rows. I don't want to say too much because it is a paid for pattern, but it's an 8 row pattern repeat. I think that's fine to say. So, yeah, I still just need to glance and see where I'm at using the pattern, but it's very pretty. And I did what she does and only did the pattern on the front so that the back is just plain stockinette. And I do think that definitely makes the sock go faster and it does give it more stretch for some patterns. So I think I'll continue doing that, but I'm using one of my stitch markers from Melissa of Knitty by Nature. And if you can't tell, I like her shop because I think I mention it every time. I think that's probably the majority of all of my progress keepers and stitch markers are from her. So I definitely do recommend her as well. But that is, I just did black and gray. They are Knit Pick Stroll Fingering. The gray is ash, and then this is just called black. So that is one Christmas project that I'm getting done, and that was just on a 2.25 Chalgu 9-inch circular, and I do like that, and it does go fairly fast. I'm just loving the toe up right now, so if it's not toe up, I'm like making myself work on it, and I need to make myself work on that more. I did get a good bit done for the past week, I think. Considering how much other stuff I got done, I think I did pretty good. And this is in my Freckled Whimsy shawl satchel bag. And let's see what is next. Okay, just two more things. And this one is, it's not been started yet, but I want to go ahead and show you. I did Eric's paddle gloves. And then this is what I'm going to be using for Austin's, which is the pair that I'm going to start next. Kind of came unwound on me there. His favorite color is green. So we picked out this. It is Barocco Vintage DK. Let me show you the tag. And this is the same yarn that I used on Eric's, just a different color. So I'm going to start these this week. I thought I would go ahead and show you the yarn. And it's all ready to go. I've got the needles in there. And like I said, I'm going to try the smaller size needle for the whole glove. His measurements say he'll need a size small. So I'm going to go ahead and start that and just keep trying it on him. Because I did do, and I don't know that I said that, I did Eric's Gloves Magic Loop. So that's what I'm going to do Austin's. And the needles that I used were Hiya Sharps. And I talked about these last week because I had used them for the first time. And I'm still loving them. I did order some more for socks for Magic Loop. And these are probably my new favorites. I love the cable. I love how sharp they are. There is no drag on the needles that I have found. So yeah, I think they've beat out Addy and Chowgu for sock needles. I do like different needles for different things, you know, but so far, Hiya Sharps are my favorite for Magic Loop. And this is just in my Doctor Who bag that I love. And this is what I'm gonna do probably all of Eric's projects in, because he's the biggest Doctor Who fan in the house. So there's that. And the last whip that I'm going to show you, I talked about last week, and I set huge goals to try to get down and get separated for the sleeves. It's a sweater. That was my goal, to be able to show you guys more, because I'm going to show it to you today, and it's not going to be very easy to really show, just because of the point it's at. You're not really going to be able to see a whole lot, but I didn't get any work done on it. I had a busy week last week getting ready for the hurricane and just different things. The boys ended up being off of school on Friday. They canceled school ahead of the storm. So I didn't get a lot done. And then I had planned to work on it over the weekend, but I don't know. Saturday, you know, we were just anxious about the storm coming and watching the weather. And Sunday, cleaning up, and I just didn't really have the brain space this weekend to work on this because it is so detailed with the lace. There's lace on the sleeves and a lace panel down the back. So yeah, I just didn't really have the space in my brain to sit down and try to figure all of it out. But I'll show you this first because I've seen this back on so many podcasts and so many people have it and love it, and I feel exactly the same. This is my huge bag from Awesome Granny, and I love this bag. I love her attention to detail, her little ring, and just how she cut the fabric so that you can really see the picture on the fabric. And then she's got a great handle. And the girls on the other side. And the fabric on the inside is great too. Little fireflies. And I love her tag. It says, "Bags by Awesome Granny. Respect your knitting." So I love that. And I especially love, I always used to catch fireflies as a child, and we would put them in jars, and my grandma and grandpa would let us keep them in our room for a little while. Sometimes they would die, very sad, but we used to catch fireflies. And then living in Florida, I don't ever remember seeing fireflies there, and definitely no fireflies in Arizona. So yeah, I love this bag because we've lived somewhere that has had no fireflies for a while. Okay, this is, I don't want to give away too much. I don't think that will. The Bloomsbury sweater. And I'm not even going to try to pronounce who that is by. I'll just put it down here. But yes, it is a paid for pattern on Ravelry. And the yarn that I am using is Cascade. And I got this at one of my local yarn shops, Weaver's Web. And I said last week that I was kind of questioning the color choice for me. And I love this color, but I'm wondering if it's going to look okay for me. This is the color that I picked. I don't know if they have colorway names or not. I don't think so. But it is this gorgeous shade of green. I hope you can see that. But I don't see a colorway name. But the color number is 802. And it is a 100% superwash merino wool. And let's show you what I've got. Like I said, you're not really going to be able to see too much of it. Just because of the place that it's at, it's kind of hard to make out. And with it being on, I've got it on circulars, so you can't really be stretched out. But let's see. Let me even figure out where I am. Okay. This is the front. And it's definitely not, I mean, it's bunched up on the cord, so. That's the front, and then here's a sleeve. And then, make sure I'm showing you this right. That is the back, and that lace goes all the way down the back. And the other sleeve is right there. So I'm pretty close to separating the sleeves off, and then, you know, I'll continue on down the body. I'm close, very, very close. But I'm wondering if this shade of green will look okay. What do you guys think? I'm hoping it will, because I bought like 9 skeins of this, so that would be a lot to then decide that the color didn't look good with me, for me. So I don't know. What do you guys think? Yay, nay? I've put a lot of work into this so far. I would hate to not do it, and I do love the color. I love it, so maybe I should just wear it anyways, regardless if it really looks that great with my skin tone and my hair. But yeah, that's that. Hopefully next week I will really have it done. I think part of my hold up, like I said, it takes a lot. You know, you're following the lace. It's just one lace chart, but you're following different sections for different parts of the sweater. So it becomes a lot. It's not a sit down and work on it for a few minutes and then get up to do something, come back to it. When I sit down to work on it, I have to commit to doing a little bit to really make it worth my time to sit down and do it, because I have to have full concentration on it to be able to keep track of my rows and where I'm at on the chart for this sleeve, where I'm at on the chart for this sleeve, and where I'm at for the back. It's an ordeal, I guess, to work on it, and it's a thicker weight than I really like to use anymore. I really want to do a finger weight sweater, because that is the yarn weight that I am just loving. But I think this will be great for this winter. Once I get it done, it'll be nice and warm and cozy. And I love it. I love the lace on it. I just need to take the time, you know, when the kids are in school, maybe spend an hour each day knocking out a few rows, and I think that would really add up over time, and I might have it done before I know it. So yeah, that is my sweater that I'm working on. And I'm wondering if I was a little too ambitious to pick this sweater. I've done a sweater for my niece, which she is just a little over one. I've done a sweater for her first birthday, and I did a sweater for Wyatt. And those are the only two sweaters I've done other than sweaters for Wyatt's Build-A-Bears. But I'm wondering if this is a little bit ambitious to do a lace sweater with that much lace for my first adult size sweater. And I'm wondering if that's my holdup. I don't know what my holdup is. I just need to get it done because I want to have the finished object to wear this winter. So yeah. And again, the gorgeous bag by Awesome Granny. And she has the YKK zippers, and I love those. They're very thick and they just feel very, very sturdy. So is that it for whips? That's it. That's all I got for whips. Okay. Now we will move on to acquisitions. And I only have one thing that came that I purchased. I have some things that I'm hoping have not gotten lost. I think the hurricane, of course, you know, has probably messed with the mail all over the East Coast. But I have some things that just say they've arrived at my post office, but they haven't moved since then. So we'll see. We'll see when they arrive, and hopefully they have not been lost. But I mentioned on a previous podcast that I've been watching Tiffany Knittin' from the Mitten podcast, and that I wanted to order some of her yarn. And the colorway is, my favorite color is October. Well, guys, I ordered it. And her shop is called The Woolen Homestead. There's her tag. And let's see. My favorite color is October. Her soft sock base, and it's 75% superwash merino and 25% nylon, 462 yards. Let me go ahead and show you this too. This is all of her information, and I'll put all that on there because I'm not sure if it'll even focus. But there is that, and it's gorgeous, and it's so squishy, so squishy. It almost does not even feel like a base that has nylon in it because it is just so squishy. I love those colors, the green and the purples and oranges. I'm really hoping I will have time to cast on some socks with this because I love this. Love this combination right here. Very, very pretty. And it's so squishy. And she included just some teas. So I can't wait to try those. The vanilla caramel. That's going to be really good. Chai is my favorite. I haven't tried that one. So that is the only thing that I purchased that came. And I do have a package here that came. I participated in a swap through the Lucky Jenny Knits podcast. She was doing a fall swap, so I signed up to be a part of that. And my swap package came from my partner, and hers is ready to go. I just did not want to mail it out ahead of the storm and have it get lost. And there were other things I wanted to grab that the farmer's market was not open. Hurricanes, guys. But her package came, and hers will be going out today. I have to finish packaging up all of my swaps and giveaways and get those out. But I am in love with the stuff that she sent. She made this project bag, and I won't mention her name. I didn't ask if it was okay to. Yes, she made this project bag. She posted a picture of it on Instagram, and I had commented that I love the fabric. And then she sent me a project bag she made, and I love it. The greens and the deer, the birds, and it's gorgeous. It has a nice handle. And then on the inside is some green fabric, and it has a pocket. Let me see. I hate to turn it inside out, but I really want to show you this fabric on the pocket because it is super cute. It says, "Creativity rules. Start somewhere. I make stuff. Made with love. Make, do, and mend." And then it has centimeters and inches. And I love that fabric. I wouldn't mind an entire bag in that fabric. It is so cute. So yeah, it has a little pocket in it. And I'm excited. I almost went ahead and put something in here, but I thought, no, I'll wait. Wait and show it first. So that's my project bag, and I love it. She also sent some local to her stuff. There is the Cozy Tea Cart Maple Walnut Tea. And I was going to go ahead and open this weekend and try it. But with the hurricane, I did not. So I cannot wait to try that. I like maple and I like walnut, so I'm sure it will be delicious. And also some little maple candies. And a little mini. And this yarn from Fish Belly Fiberworks on Etsy. And it is 100% superwash merino, and the color is maple leaves in the mail. And there is approximately 400 yards. And there's the color for, or the card for the shop. And I love these colors. Absolutely love it. I would say that fall is probably, I say right now it's my favorite season, but when Christmas comes, Christmas will be my favorite. I don't know. I don't know that I could decide between the two. Spring and summer, okay, I don't like the heat of summer, but I love the colors of fall, and I love the spirit of Christmas. There we go. And I like the colors of Christmas too. I do go a little crazy decorating. Anyways, guys, I think I've rambled more today than I have any episode. Okay. This is gorgeous. I've got to decide what I'm going to make with this. I'm thinking it would be pretty in a shawl. But I don't know what colors I should pair with it. And last but not least, because we had a full conversation about this after I saw that she had sent me this, because this is my go-to tool in my Notions pouch, and I'm constantly losing it in the cushions of my couch, or I'm losing it in a project bag and not remembering which bag it's in, so I'm having to dig for it. So now I have two, and I love this. If you guys have not tried the Susan Bates handy tool, you have got to try it. It has got, let me go ahead and open it so I can show you. I'm sure the majority of you have seen these before. They are amazing. They've got that sharp tip, and it's not super, super sharp. It's pretty blunt, but a tip on the one end for picking up stitches. And then you could use this. It's got a little crochet hook on the other end that you could use for picking up stitches as well. And I've even used this as a cable needle when I'm doing cables and I don't feel like getting a cable needle out, and I've got this handy. I'll use it for cables, or if I do a gusset and a heel flap, I usually use the crochet end to pick up stitches along the gusset. So, yeah, you need to get one of these or a bunch, because she said she has a ton, and I'm thinking that's what I need to do because I'm constantly losing them. At least now I'll have two. But I need to buy more so that I have them when I do lose them, because it happens. And I've always eventually found the one that I do have. But now at least I have two. So yes, and full wonderful package. And I was so excited, all the little goodies, and that she sent local stuff, because I love that. In a swap, getting something local that you get to try out is so much fun. So thank you, thank you, thank you. And that is it for acquisitions, I believe. Yes. Like I said, stuff just hasn't came. Hopefully next week there'll be more. My husband probably says, hopefully not. But I don't even think he watches this. Maybe. Okay. Podcast left. I don't have two this week. I've only got one, partly because I did not really get to watch a lot of podcasts this past week, or really get caught up. I'm pretty behind. I just had a busy week, and then the weekend we didn't have power. I usually watch them on my Kindle Fire, and we had no Wi-Fi, so I couldn't watch it on that. But I thought this was pretty cool, so I wanted to mention it. We have Verizon for our cell service, and they sent out, we got a notification Sunday morning, I believe, from Verizon, just how they sent out the little alerts by text, saying that they were going to cover any overage for data, text, and talk, yes. From, I can't remember what the start date was, but it ended the 11th, which is today, right, I think? But that they would cover all of that. And I'm assuming it went out to customers within the areas that were hit by the hurricane. But I thought that was so nice, because that was one thing we were concerned about. I mean, of course, we could just not use our phones, but it's so easy to get on there and keep up to date with family and, you know, all the stuff that you're accustomed to doing, checking your emails, all of that, that you cannot do when you do not have power or Wi-Fi. So that, I just thought that was great of Verizon, because that would have, you know, of course, been an opportunity where they could have probably earned a bunch of money with people going over on their plans, whether it be data, text, or talk. So I thought that was cool, and I wanted to mention that. But yeah, so I did not get a ton of podcast watch over the weekend. I've got some catching up to do this week. But I did want to mention one that is fairly new to me. I've been watching her for a little while. She's got a few episodes on there. Can't remember what she's up to now. But I love her, and she is so sweet. She lives in Singapore. Her name is Fatima, and she is the Nick. I knew I was going to mess that up. Knit Knacker Natters podcast. And I love listening to her. She is originally from the UK, and I love listening to her accent. And she talks about her life in Singapore. And she's just an amazing knitter, and she's working on some gorgeous shawls right now. And not only knit one, she's working on a crochet one right now that is a blue and like a creamy white collar, I believe. And it is so pretty, and it kind of makes me want to get out my crochet hooks and try a crochet shawl, because I've never really liked the crochet shawl patterns that I've seen, but the one that she's working on is very, very gorgeous. So definitely check out Fatima. She is, like I said, super sweet, and her voice is just very soothing to listen to. I don't know, I enjoy listening and watching her podcasts. So give her a check out. That doesn't even make any sense. Oh my goodness, guys. I almost did not record today. I was on the fence about it. I had not really thought about it. I didn't think we were going to have power. So I just did not think about it. I wasn't preparing or, you know, working on show notes. So I sat down last night and I worked on show notes really quick. Got those all wrote out. Figured out what I was going to show and talk about. And then my oldest you know, didn't feel good this morning, and we decided that he would stay home. So I was not sure what I was going to talk about today, or if I was even going to podcast. But here I am. I've rambled. I hope it has made some sense. I don't know. But week ahead, I don't have any huge plans this week. Like I said, I've got a lot to catch up on from being without power for a few days. Laundry needs caught up, some cleaning. You know, we've got two dogs, and we were not able to run the vacuum all weekend, so that is like top priority on my list, laundry and run the vacuum. But yeah, that's about all I'm gonna be doing, knitting and getting the house back to normal. Like I said, I wanna cast on Austin's gloves. Maybe I'll have his one Halloween sock done, maybe one Christmas sock, be to the lace on my cupcake shawl, do a row on my sweater. Oh goodness, guys. Okay, I think that's pretty much it. I've rambled enough this morning. How long have I been talking? About an hour. And I really did, I thought when I started, okay, this will probably be a short one. An hour, oh my goodness. Thank you to those of you that stick around for an hour and come back to watch another hour of me talking to a camera. So thank you so much, and that's it. The endings, I had heard people say, I'm gonna ramble again for a minute. When I started watching podcasts, you hear a few people say that the most awkward parts are the beginning and the end. Those are where you do not know what to say to start it, and you don't know what to say to end it. And I totally get it. The starting is not too bad. I do feel a little awkward until I really get into it and get comfortable talking to myself, I guess. But the endings, so bad. I always feel like I either, you know, you either ramble on or it's just like, okay, see ya. I don't know. But yes, I'm going to get this mess cleaned up. I've got to get swap packages and giveaway packages ready. So if you're expecting anything from me, barring some horrible disaster, they will be going out today. I'm assuming the post office has power. Fingers crossed, we will see. But yeah, gonna do that. I've gotta go get something for my son, some cough drops and something, some kind of cold medicine. I'm thinking his allergies might have kind of went to a little bit of a cold here. Got something a little bit more going on now maybe. So I'm gonna go get him something stronger than Zyrtec. And hopefully he will feel better. His brother was not very happy this morning that he had to ride the bus by himself to begin with, and then the fact that they have to go around this morning and this afternoon because the ferry is closed. He was a sad little boy this morning. He took some books, and yeah, he'll get a lot of reading done. Maybe he even took a nap. I'd imagine that's a good time to take a nap. Bus for that long.